I keep it. Two things and I'll close. Just look at the time on my phone. I'll put this down so that you know. So good to have Scott and Amber Brooks with us. Pastors of Three Nations of East Texas. We're so glad they're here in New Boston, Texas. Formerly our youth pastors. And while I mention them, I want you to be in prayer for them. I had thought their house had sold here because it was supposed to have been. I didn't realize the deal actually fell through, the people who buying it. So they're juggling two homes and Jesus. The brand new church. So they need our prayers.
Yes.
So keep Scott and Amber in your prayers. Keep it, guys. Keep your mission.
Yes.
Keep your music. Yeah, I really thought the only thing, that's all I had till this morning. I thought that was it. Keep your mission. Keep it. You know, the things that I've mentioned is the specific things that we all know. But no. He went on to say, keep your music. Hang on to your CDs. Hang on to your, you know, the stuff on your phone when you plug it in. Bluetooth, yeah. Keep your music. That music in your soul. The music in your soul. I'm not talking about that honky tonk sleeping with somebody else's wife, running around and getting drunk. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about keep that music that moves you into the presence of God. Keep that music that are sounds that are coming from heaven. That somebody who knew how to write music and somebody who knew how to sing, because I don't know how to put all those lyrics together, and I sure can't sing. But somebody else who can is gifted with that, and is a modern day psalmist. They got in the presence of the Lord, and their calling is to be a modern day psalmist. And they pull down that sound from heaven.
Hallelujah!
And that music gets in your soul.
Come on now,
amen.
Just recently, I heard a song that I hadn't heard. I think it's been out a while, but I just want to worship. I've asked the worship team to work on it. They just did a new one for us today that they've been working on. That was so powerful.
Amen.
Heaven come.
Amen.
So awesome.
Amen.
I just want to worship. Yeah. When I first heard that song, often I can. Am I here patting myself on the back of them better than you know? No. We're all growing in this thing. He's still working on one. He's still working on us.
Right.
But usually, about the first 10 to 15 seconds, 20 seconds into a song, I can tell you, or at least for me, I can sense that is a sound from heaven.
That's right.
Yeah.
Because it captures me. It catches me up into the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
Just boom,
right.
That quick.
Yes.
And when I heard that by Kim DeMarco, I don't know how to say that.
Christine DeMarco.
DeMarco, thank you. Kim DeMarco. When I first heard that song, the first 10 seconds, I was just in his presence. Right there, boom. 10 seconds, boom, I'm in his presence.
That's so cool.
I'm in the natural. 10 seconds, I'm in the supernatural.
Amen.
Praise God.
She wrote the song, put music to it, modern day songs. It's not about her or many across the world that God is using. And that's not to say that amazing grace doesn't catch me up into his presence.
Right.
So I'm not saying, you understand what I'm saying.
Yes.
Right. But in 10 seconds, I'm captured by him listening to that song. And so for about a week, I just went around replaying it. Just playing it all the time.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Good simulation, I like it.
And then, you know, another song will just catch me up in his presence. I just want to keep my song.
Yeah.
Then it's something, sometimes it's just a song that nobody else is singing or I haven't heard in a long time. And it just gets in my spirit as I'm planting myself close to those waters. And when you keep your music, there's something, we've been talking about it later, but I can't get away from it. This wasn't going to be in my notes, but God said, add it, tell them, keep your music. Worship, it's our first line of defense. You need to keep your music. You need to keep your song. This is what the Bible says about you. All the days of your life, do you understand the one that we sing to and we sing about has been singing over you all your life. He's been singing over you all your life. And the Bible says the songs that he sings over you are songs of deliverance. Yeah. Even when you're backpedaling, even when you're dropping stuff and losing stuff, he doesn't give up on you. He's singing over you. Songs of deliverance. The angels of heaven are surrounding you. And songs of deliverance are singing, being sung around you. Even when you're backpedaling, because he knows. You love him and he loves you back. He's not mad. Let me catch you. Let me help you. Get a grip. Come on, get back there. Pick it back up. Let's go. Now get by the waters. Dig in. Day's coming for that circumstantial breakthrough.